Good morning. Good morning to you. Good morning. Let me say that one more time. Good morning to you. Amen. Good morning and Merry Christmas. Y'all got y'all Christmas colors on. That's why I know it's Christmas. That's how I know. Amen. Good morning to you and Merry Christmas and happy birthday to our Christ. Amen. To God's Son. Amen. It's certainly, it's Christmas time and I'm excited. You still excited about Christmas? And amen. It's still a joyous time of the year. And so how we thank God for blessing us, to be a part of another day. Amen. Another day that we get to praise Him. We get to exalt Him. Amen. We get to celebrate our risen King. He's a risen King. And so we thank God for our salvation and for giving us the wisdom to know the real meaning of Christmas. Amen. To know the real meaning of Christmas. All right. We're going to begin to celebrate, amen, the Lord's special day. And so I want to invite you to join in with our music ministry. Good morning to our viewing audience. Amen. I hope you up. I hope you hit somebody up and say, hey, St. John is on. Amen. Invite your friends to celebrate Christ with us this Sunday morning. Would you do that? I hope you do that. Call somebody and tell them, hey, it is the Sunday before Christmas. Amen. Normally the churches are packed across the world. On this particular Sunday, there are, what is it, Christmas programs, and oh man, it's just a big thing, a big deal. And so let's celebrate Christ. Let's not let our praise be dampened, amen, by what's going on, and let's celebrate our risen King. Amen. All right.
Morning, family. I know we have our masks on this morning, but if y'all can help me lift this, some of these songs. Silent night. Oh, tell it on the mountain, over the hill and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is more. Help me sing it, dance it, go.
Give the Lord a hand clap of praise. I know this is the Christmas season, but let us not ever forget the reason for the season. Amen. God's precious gift to you, to me, and to the world. To our viewing audience, welcome to another St. John Baptist Church morning service. May this service be a blessing to you today. Amen. Let us stand for the reading of God's word. And we encourage you too in the viewing audience to open your Bibles and turn the pages to Isaiah chapter 9, verses 6 through 7. That's Isaiah chapter 9. A familiar passage. So good to hear those pages turn. All right. And we're going to read from the NIV. And the word of the Lord reads, "For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness. From that time on and forever, the zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this." Amen. Amen. The world is seeking for justice, peace, and there's nothing wrong with that. But there will be no permanent peace and righteousness and justice until the Prince of Peace establish his kingdom, physical kingdom on earth. Amen. I believe that. Do you? All right, I believe that. Let us go before the Lord in prayer. And Father, it's so good to know that one day you will establish peace, righteousness, and justice here on this earth. But in the meantime, we are to live holy, to do right, to worship you, to love our fellow man, and to love each other. So we bless you this morning for waking us up to see another beautiful day with you, man. We thank you for the transportation of getting us all here this morning. We thank you for the cold to kill all the germs and bacteria in the air. You're a good God, and you know exactly what we need when we need it. And we thank you so much for knowing that we need a Savior. A Savior born in Bethlehem, who walked this earth for 33 years, a ministry of 3 years, and then he died a death that no one could do but him. And he rose again, and he sits right now on the right hand with you, making intercession for us. And so, Lord, thank you for taking our prayers to the Father. Father, we're here to worship you this morning, and we want to worship you in spirit and in truth. And so we ask you, oh God, to forgive us of sin. And we thank you that through the blood of Jesus, our sins are forgiven. We must do is confess and forsake them. And you hold our, you don't hold it against us no more. And so now, Lord, as we continue on in worship, we thank you for Ricky and him leading us in worship. And we pray for our pastor who's gonna come up and give us a special message today. A message that will minister to the hearts of men, women, boys, and girls. Use him in a mighty way. Anoint him from his head down to his feet. Clear his mind. Every muscle in his body. Give him strength. Musicians, Lord, we just thank you for them. We pray and bless them. And the singers will accompanying Ricky, use them too, Lord, for your glory, because it's all about you and not us. Remember those who are newly elected in our offices, government offices today, and from our newly elected president and vice, senators and congressmen and mayors and governors and the whole shop. So we just thank you now. And we bless your holy name. Before I close, I want to pray for those who are sick among this body. Just a few names: Sister Sheila, Brother Glenn Howard, a few others that are sick, who've lost loved ones, that you would touch and heal today. In Jesus' name, amen.
Glory to God.
sometimes I think to myself, and I just want to put us in recognition of the magnitude of our Lord. When the brother said he fell dead at the Savior's feet, just I want to put us in the magnitude of who God is. Glory to God. If you could just lift up your voice and sing with me today. This is a holy song for the church to sing. And if you aren't too holy, hopefully you listen to some of this on your daily life.
Redeemer, God with us, yeah. God with us, yeah.
Come on, church. Say, you are the living word.
You are the living word.
Thank you, God, for your mercy and your grace.
You are the living word.
You are the living word.
Lord Jesus, thank you for you, Lord. Thank you for coming down to save me.
You are the living word.
You are the living word.
Say, you are the living word.
You are the living word.
Oh, you are the living word.
You are the living word.
God, a hand clap of praise. Bless his name. Hallelujah. Thank you so much. Amen. That is the meaning of Christmas. Amen. Amen. That is what it's all about. Christ coming to save us from sin. That's why he came. Amen. Sometimes we try to break it up and just talk about his birth. But it's hard to just talk about his birth without talking about the reason why he came. Amen. Unlike there be some gifts under the tree, you won't figure out why. Why they gave me this. Amen. 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 As I get older, it's like, don't give me a gift like that, you know. I get it myself, right? Just, amen. You don't know the meaning of it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want us to, this Sunday, as I was thinking about today, I say, on this Sunday, let's slow it down and let's take a little deeper dive for Christmas, right? And so I want us today look at Luke chapter 1, verse 32, and Galatians chapter 4, verse 4 through 7 today. While you're looking for that, I want us to think about just who we are, and that is that we are children of the Most High. You know, Christ is King, and for you and I, Christmas is about you and I being children of the Most High. That's what it means for you and I. In Luke chapter 1, verse 32, very familiar passage. It says, he will be great. I could wait. Excuse me. Give you a chance to get there. Luke chapter 1, verse 32. It says, he will be great and he will be called the Son of the Most High. Amen. Galatians, go to Galatians chapter 4. Amen. Paul was dealing with some people who had a misunderstanding about the gospel of Jesus Christ. And he was trying to help them know there's only one gospel. And look what he says here in that verse 4. But when the time had fully come, God sent his son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those under the law, that we might receive the full rights of sons and daughters. Because you are sons and daughters, God sent his spirit of his son into our hearts, the spirit who cries out, Abba, Father. So you are no longer a slave, but a son, a daughter, right? And since you are sons and daughters of God, God has made you also an heir. An heir. Amen. God, how we praise you, how we lift you up, how we adore you, how we bless your name. We thank you, God, again for just being such an awesome God, a caring God. We give you praise and glory, God. You're worthy today of all our praise. We thank you, God, for Jesus the Christ, your Son, and our Savior. Thank you for Jesus, and he means the world to us. Amen. There's no life without Jesus. And so we thank you this morning for Jesus the Christ, the one who came, lived and died and rose and who's alive. It's in that name we pray. We ask you, God, to forgive us of all our sins. Cleanse us, God, through and through. It's in your presence. We're mindful of our own creatureliness, our own imperfections. And so we ask you, God, to cleanse us and make us strong. Fix us, God, to worship you in spirit and in truth. Thank you for allowing us to worship already in our singing and the reading of your word and our music. Even now we pray in this preaching moment, you'd fill the preacher as well as the hearers with your word and with your spirit. Be careful to give you praise and give you glory, for it's in Jesus' name we pray. We do thank you, and church say amen. 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 I was thinking about this Sunday and looking at Paul's comments over in Galatians, and it reminds me that Christmas is about God giving us an opportunity to become children of God. Amen. Christmas is about God giving us an opportunity to become children of God. Not everybody are children of God. Not everybody celebrating Christmas are children of God. But Christmas, this gift that God gave to the world, is about you and I having this opportunity to be called the children of God. And it's through this gift, it's through this Christ, that we experience God. You and I wouldn't know God had it not been for this gift at Christmas. At least that's the Christian faith. It might be other folk that believe something different, but if you are a Christian, you know that there was no way for you and I to have a relationship with God, to know God without Jesus. And so isn't that a wonderful gift that God has given us, that he, in giving us Christ, he gave us access to him. Amen. He allowed us to get to know him through Jesus Christ. Amen. And so at Christmas time, you know, we ought to be mindful of what was gained. What was gained, you know, when Jesus came into the world, you and I gained something. I mean, Christ is that gift, you know, that you've heard it before, you know, it's the gift that keeps on giving and it keeps on living, right? All right. I mean, there are gifts and things that we're going to do going to be great for a few days, maybe a month, you know, maybe they, some of this stuff might make it to the summer. But it's become old and it's going to be sitting off in a corner somewhere or under something. But that's not true with Jesus. The gift of Christ at Christmas is a gift that keeps giving. It's a gift that keeps living. There's no expiration date. You don't have to charge it. You don't have to get batteries for it. Right. You know, he still, look, he has this power that, that when he walked into your life, right, it was that same power, amen, that you can count on today. You'll be able to count on it tomorrow. It's that same presence, you know, that you can count on today. You can count on tomorrow, right? And so Christ, to be a child of God, you know, man, that is a big deal, to have God as our Father. And so when you read your Bible, the angels report to Mary, it makes news that the child you're carrying, he is the Son. He is the Son of the Most High. Amen. Amen. That term Most High, anytime it show up in the Old Testament or the New, is talking about God. It's only one somebody who have that title. Now, there might be somebody else that have your title, you know, but this one here, only God have this title, Most High. And so Christ, when you say Christ is the Son of the Most High, it tells us this is not just your average baby. Because Son of the Most High places deity on him. It says that Jesus Christ is not Mary's and Joseph's child. Because Mary and Joseph, for one, they're not sinless, you know, and they're not Most High. They somebody God used. Amen. But the Most High is the child, is the Christ who is our King. Paul wanted to straighten some people out who was preaching a different gospel. And Paul, in this Galatian text, I think it's in that first chapter, is when he tell them there's really no such thing as another gospel. In other words, Paul says, really nothing for me to debate because there's no such thing as another gospel. There's just one. There's just one gospel. And so Paul, in order to make his case and explain to his viewing audience that just who Jesus, who this Christ, who he is, and then what it means to you and I on this Sunday morning. Paul, in this Galatian text, he makes the point by talking about the birth of Christ, but without any genealogy. He's not dealing with who begot who and all of that. Like John just jumps over and say, in the beginning was the Word. John don't even do it. John says, since we're going to be talking about Jesus, I don't want to confuse y'all talking about Joseph and Mary, because some of y'all might stay there. And so John said, looky here, let me just put it this way, that before there was a Joseph or Mary, there was a Word. That's the way John worked with that thing, right? The word was with God, the Word was God, and the Word became flesh. Amen. And, you know, so John go that route. But then Paul, in a way, he's doing that because Paul, when he began to talk about this gospel and what it is, Paul says in the gospel is where you and I will find that we are children of the Most High God. That if you're preaching the gospel the right way, that you will know that you are more than just your parents' child. That when you had faith, when you placed faith in Christ, that you became what? A child of God. And so Paul said it kind of goes this way. Paul says in that verse 4, he says, but when the time had fully come. But, you know, he says, but now when the time had fully come, Paul is talking about God's time, that do you know God has a time when things get to the level when God want to do something, you know, it's when time has fully come. That Christmas, you know, and you can shout here, is that there's something that you don't have to fret too much about, and you don't have to worry about whether or not God will come, because Paul says God has a time. God has a time. When God get tired of watching you and I cry at night, when he get tired of seeing you and I worry about stuff you can't do nothing about, when God get tired of watching us trying to figure things out and trying to work things out, Paul says, God, look, when time has fully come, you know, in other words, he's saying at a time set or at a set time, God made a move. And so Jesus didn't just accidentally come into the world. He came in the world at a set time. He came at a set time. Look at here. Look, the world was jacked up like it is right now. The world needed a savior when he showed up. And do you know what? And the world need a savior now. But the shout is, I don't have to be waiting on the savior to come, because Paul says he already been here. That at the fullness of time or at a set time, God did something. God did something. This thing is fully under the control of God. You know, this birth of Christ is fully under the control of God. And so Paul says it happens in God's own time. And then he says Christ wasn't an accidental pregnancy or nothing like that. Paul says that Paul says, don't look at your children. I know you really wanted to have them. Paul says that Jesus was a baby who was sent. Yeah. He was. See, he was sent. See, you ought to be able to worship and praise God, because God, look, God is intentional about saving us, about wanting to bless you. God is intentional about that. And so Christ is sent into the world. Jesus and God the Father had a conversation in heaven, and God probably said to Jesus, nobody, none of my prophets been able to deliver. I mean, all of my prophets, no matter how good, no matter how powerful they were, they all struggled in their flesh. They all struggled when it came to the law. He said they was just not strong enough, good enough to really redeem man, to really reconcile man back to us. And so the Bible says that Jesus agrees in heaven. Yes, he was in heaven first. He agrees in heaven that I go down there where there's bigotry and bias and hatred, where there's poor people and hungry people and food deserts. Yes, I'll go. And not just save some of them. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Southern Baptists struggling right now about systemic racism. They're struggling whether or not all of us, whether or not God love everybody. But he didn't just come in the world to save the elite. You know, he didn't just come in the world for a certain class or a certain group of people. Now, Jesus came in the world where there's bigotry and bias and prejudice and an unjust world. He came in that world to save us. To save us. Christ is sent into the world. Y'all, I know y'all say, what are you talking about? This is a Christmas. Yeah. Yeah, it says he was God. When the time came, he sent his son. Now, here it is where God is bad. He is bad. I mean, you know, God, look, you would think that he would. Have you guys watched that movie Iron Man? You know, he couldn't get justice in his flesh. He had to put on an outfit. Right? Right. He had to step into that thing. I kind of felt like him right there. Right, right. You know, he had to step in that thing, right? But once he was in that, once he got in the Iron Man outfit, he can reconcile, he can handle business. Well, check God out. God is bad. God gonna use a woman. See, it was old girl in Genesis that messed up in the garden. And so God said, I'm gonna use old girl again. Huh? You know, because look, she don't have a good portfolio, but God said, but I'm about to use her, so I'm gonna use old girl again. And then he said, and look, and they struggled with the law. So he said, I'm coming in the world, born of a woman, and born under the law. God says, I'm about to help Price, I'm gonna deliver Price by conquering the stuff he can't handle. Look, he can't always handle his flesh. That's our humanity. See, in our humanity, not in our spirit self, where God get all the praise in our spirit you. It's in your flesh is what you got to pray the most about. You ain't got to pray too much about your spirit. But look here, look, if y'all mess with me the wrong way today on the Sunday before Christmas, it'll be my humanity that might show up too much. You ought to be praising God right now that he got control of your humanity. And so Jesus came, look, in our humanity, and he came under the law because what? We can't keep the law. You know, we can't, even on your best day, you just can't do it. I know some of y'all still trying to keep the law, but the law is our problem. The Bible said that the law reveals our sins. It don't help you handle your sins. Huh? The law tell you don't do that. And your flesh say, but it's all right. The law just sit here and you can look at it. You know, it just tell you you shouldn't. But it don't have no stop you power. And so in the fullness of time, huh? You and I are children of the Most High because God says, I'm coming in the world in the person of Jesus Christ, and I'm going to conquer the stuff that we can't handle. And that's why you ought to be able to shout on a Sunday morning. You ought to be able to shout at Christmas time, because Christmas time is really about God coming in the world to handle stuff you and I just could not handle. Look at here. And look at all of us, if the truth be told, what? We are just riding on his coattail. When somebody, what? When the world give you a hard time, you just turn them to Jesus. Huh? You got to tell your enemy, you staring at me too long. You staring, look, you taking me too seriously, baby. Look at here. Let me just tell you, I ain't all that. Look at here. Whatever I am, it's in Christ Jesus. Huh? God is in control of this thing. And God, look at here. God has power to allow you and I to rise up in the same place where we fall. That's God. God big enough to do that. He could look, God can elevate us in the places where the enemy thought he had you bound, where he thought he had taken you out. This verse is about a God in heaven who can elevate us in the same places where you fail. He can turn that thing around. And that's what Christmas is all about. When you are a child of the King, when you are a child of the Most High, your praise is about God doing stuff for you that you couldn't do for yourself. He was born of a woman, and he was under the law. Look what he said. He did it to what? To redeem those under the law. Huh? That's all of us. Christ came to redeem us. He came to recover. You know. Lucky here, sin had us bound, right? We were left out of the kingdom at one time. But Christ coming is about reclaiming. It's about recovering what belongs to God. That's part of that Christmas story, y'all. It's about Him paying a ransom. It's about Him coming to redeem us. And He says, look, not just some of us, but He redeems those, all of us who are born under the law, all of us who are born in this human flesh needed to be redeemed. Look, we are not all His children, but we can. I hope somebody watching me on this Sunday morning, I want you to know, you can be His child. Amen. He came, what, in the world to redeem you. I know you looking at yourself this Sunday morning and you don't see any redemptive value in yourself. Because society has given up on you. Maybe folk that you thought loved you have given up on you. But the Christmas story is all about folk who was not redeemable, but God in His kindness and His loving kindness, God what? Redeemed. Look, God purchases something that everybody else leave in the store. Huh? Yeah, you and I are those Christmas gifts that's F on the shelves on December the 26th. We still on the shelf in the store, been pushed around. Folk didn't open us up and just pushed us to the side. And Christmas is about God going in that store and getting items off the shelves that folk left behind that nobody wanted. Yeah, He's the God that redeems. All of His children been redeemed. Huh? That's why I don't want to come to church and act like He ain't delivered me from nothing. Some of y'all miss your shout because y'all come to church and forgot that you've been redeemed. You know, you might be smelling good today and, dressing better today. And, but look at here, all of us been redeemed. He got us out from under what cursed us. Then he says, look, we have received the full rights as sons and daughters. Do y'all see that? Christmas, when you're talking about you a child of the Most High, he said, you and I have received already, past tense. You and I already have all the rights as sons and daughters of God. Huh? Look, guys, you know what? I don't have that much, but my kids, they don't have to sweat it. If they call me, huh? They know I'm gonna do the best I can. Right? Right? One of the grandkids, I had that talk with one of my grands. I had to let her know, look, if you call my number, I'm gonna respond. Right? I don't want you to ever be sitting no place in life thinking you don't have nobody. Right? You could holler at Big Pop. Right? Because you a child, you an heir of Big Pop. And so it doesn't matter. All you got to do, look, is hit me up. And see, all of us, Paul says, not just certain class of people have this relationship with God, but not just a certain group of people gonna have access to things in the kingdom. Not just a certain group of people, you know, gonna make it. He says that all of us, all of us who are born in this flesh, look, who are handcuffed by the law. He said, Christ, this baby Jesus, has redeemed all of us. That's your shout. That you've been redeemed. You ain't almost. He's not working on you. Huh? You know, you stop singing that song, please be patient with me. God is through with you. He is really through with you. Ain't none of us that difficult that he's still trying. If you don't feel whole, that's on your end. See, that's on your end. Whatever you feel like you don't have, that's really on your end. Huh? I don't walk in my house and wish I had a Coke. I know where the Coke's at. Huh? Anybody? You don't open up your refrigerator and wish you had a steak and it's right there.
Come on.
Huh? When you a child of the Most High, you got to think different and start living different, right? Because you already been redeemed. Whatever is in heaven, it's really for you. Okay, y'all. I don't want to get excited, but look, let me just finish my little comments and sit down with my little Easter Christmas story. He says that as children, we cry or we call to him, Abba Father. It's like calling your daddy. Do you know, in the relationship with God, the best you can be is a child? He like us to be children. He know you're grown folk. But he'd like you to relate to him as a child. He really likes the idea that you and I see him as a loving father. That when you call him, you say daddy. There's some pride in children calling a parent, the father, daddy, and the mother, mama. It's a loving, you know, it's an endearing kind of thing because it's the one somebody in your world that really looks up to you. You know, they may not look up to you on your job. Nobody might look up to you over here at this church because all of us are major baller shot callers. We ain't impressed with nobody. All of us got it like that over here. And so it's hard to impress us. But it's your children that make you feel like somebody when they stay in a child's place. And when you stay in a child's place, look, you cry out to them. You say, you call them daddy. Not JC. That's disrespectful. You don't get to eyeball him like that. You didn't show up when he showed up to be talking like that with him. But if you really want him to move on your behalf, you got to drop that JC stuff and you got to cry out to him, Abba Father. You got to say, Daddy. Yeah, 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 yeah. Huh? I like Paul, man. I really like Paul's writings. Look how Paul says, when you understand you're a child, he talks about this adoption. It's really what he's saying. We are sons and daughters. You know, Paul's ministry was to Gentiles, not to Jews. And the Jews thought they were the only ones had it going on. And Paul is saying to them, not quite the truth, that God don't have any stepchildren. There's no class system here. He says, Paul had to help them understand the, you know, sonship through adoption. That Paul was saying, the people I'm preaching the gospel to, they might not be Jews, but they have the same rights and privileges as you. They have the same rights and privileges as you. And if I was political right here, you can go there. You can. You could really slide right into that. That God want all of us. You know, if it's that way in heaven, that's the way he wants it on earth. The right understanding of God in heaven on earth is that God want all of us to have the same rights and privileges. He wants that for the Gentile believer as well as the Jewish believer. That the Jews and Gentiles are all a part of sonship. They all are sons and daughters of God. Yet nobody is better than anybody. All of us are God's children. And then he wraps that thing up, and I'm out of y'all way. He says, so since we've been adopted, he says, since we've been redeemed, he said, don't be calling me nothing that I'm not anymore. Y'all see right there, he said, and I'm out of y'all way. He says, so you are no longer a slave. You know, I don't know what you were before Jesus. But Christmas is about what? You no longer. You are no longer whatever you were before Jesus. Boy, that y'all to be waving at your boy right now. Boy, ain't that a good gift? That there's some stuff we didn't even like about ourselves. That because of Jesus Christ, look, I'm no longer that. You know, my enemies might want to label me. They might want to tag me. They might want to keep me in my place. But when Jesus came into my life, when I received Christ as Lord and King, I am no longer what I used to be. Now he says, we are heirs. You know, that means somebody have an estate. Somebody got something. And Paul is saying, since everything belonged to God, since all the silver and gold belong to God, since all power in heaven and earth is in that particular name, Paul is saying, stop living, St. John, under your old you. Christmas is about you getting a whole new makeover. It's about God wiping out your checkered past. It's about you being broke and yet possessing everything. And it's not what's in your bank account. It's not in your power. Your shout is about is who your daddy is. It's who's your daddy. You ought to just wave at your neighbor and ask your neighbor, who's your daddy this Sunday morning? Who's your daddy this Sunday morning? Now, if God is your daddy, what? He is what? He is the Lord of all lords. He is the King of all kings. He is the Alpha and Omega. He is the beginning and the end. He is the great I Am. Right here, when you're so, you ought to just say right here, let the redeemed say so. If there's anybody up in here been redeemed. Hallelujah. We are children of the Most High God. And because we are children of the Most High God, we can count on God to do whatever God promised He will do. What? God will do it. All of His promises are yes concerning you this Sunday morning. I'm in my seat. Y'all been kind. I hope you remember this Christmas that you are somebody. I want you to know that you are somebody. You are children of the Most High God. And so you got to walk around like that. You got to pull your shoulders back. You got to pop your collar. You know, you got to keep your head up. It's not because you got it like that. It's because of who your daddy is. He's worthy today of your praise. He is. This is more than a gift you wrapping up. Don't make this thing about a gift you wrapping. But make it about the real reason. The real reason. It's about who we became. And it's about who made it possible for you to be called a child of God, a child of the Most High. That's Jesus. That's that gift that it keeps giving. And He's worthy. He's worthy today. We can't let a pandemic, we can't let COVID rob you of this joy. You still gotta have joy this Christmas. If you still here, stop talking about 2020 was just bad. Not if you still here. I mean, people say that. I'm like, what are they talking about? You not on no ventilator. You not in ICU. If God is keeping you, watch how far you go. I understand Lamentations. We need that too. But let that make you thankful. Let those tears of sorrow because of the human suffrage we see, let us cry out to God for His comforting presence. But don't lose the joy that God is keeping you in this moment. Shout about how quick they got a vaccine. You ought to shout about that. They told you it'd take 2, 3, 4 years, and here it is in less than a year, people taking a shot. You ought to praise God for that. I understand our fears and talking about what happened back in the day when you can't trust nobody, but don't stay there too long. Because disproportionately, people of color are dying from it. So black and brown people ought to be dancing in the street that they have a vaccine. You ought to be praising God that helped and made it here. Yeah. Watch. Don't mess up your joy. Don't steal God's glory by being too horizontal. Have a vertical fixation. Keep your eye. That's the key. And when you do that, you see who you really are in Christ Jesus. I want to extend the invitation this morning. Y'all been great. I hope God has said something that blessed you real good at home, in our viewing audience. Look, I don't want you to leave this service this Sunday morning not knowing Jesus the Christ. It'd be a shame on a Sunday like today when you find out about what all I have in Jesus and I leave church without him. If you're here today and you don't know him as your personal savior, you can receive him today just by your faith. It's faith in him that saves you. Faith in Christ that he actually lived, actually died, actually rose from his grave. That he's alive, seated at the right hand of God in heaven. One day he's coming back to receive his church for himself. I want to be in that number and I want you to be in that number. And if you're with us today, you don't know Christ as your personal savior, I want you to receive him today by faith. We want to rejoice with you. The Bible declares heaven rejoices when one is saved. And so I want to rejoice with you and heaven over your relationship, this newfound joy in Christ Jesus. Maybe you're with us, viewing audience as well, and you're already saved, you've already accepted Christ, you've been baptized, and you're watching us this Sunday morning, you're unchurched, in between church. I know this season that we're in has made it difficult for you to get out and go to church, but you've been viewing, you've been watching church, and you are with us this Sunday morning, and God is pushing, he's nudging you, amen, to get in church, to be a part of a church. We love to have you come and be a part of the St. John Baptist Church family. You can come by letter, by statement, Christian experience. You can say, Pastor Price, man, I love the Lord. I'm saved. I've been baptized. And God is just telling me I need to get in church. And I believe he's nudging me to be a part of St. John Baptist Church. We love to have you come. Call us, email us, and we'll take it from there. We just want you in church before this year ends. We want you to have a covering. Amen. We want you to have a covering. Amen. Amen. I want you to know that God loves you today just the way you are. God, we thank you today for your word. Thank you for your spirit. Thank you, God, that who we are. We are now children of God. Amen. Because of the work of Christ Jesus. We receive that. Help us, God, to walk in who we are in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. All right. We're about out of here. We're going to lift our offering from you on your way out. Amen, amen. Hey, is Deacon Childress here yet? Amen. All right. I think so. Mm-hmm. In the back, right? Yeah. All right. We're about ready to go. On your way out, you can give your offering on your way out this morning. Amen. Thank you so much for supporting the work of the Lord here. We cannot do what we do without your support. And so thank you so much for sowing into the church this year. Thank you so much for doing that. Amen. God will continue to richly bless you. I really believe that he will. I know he will. Let me wish all of you a Merry Christmas. Amen. Merry Christmas. Be safe this Christmas. Don't have a lot of folk, at the house and all of that. Y'all keep those social distancing. Just stay with the ones you're with, the ones you've been with, right? We want all of us to get through this thing together. I thank God for how he has really blessed our church. We've had members who've been sick, but God got them through. He got them over. And so we thank God. We thank God for that. We thank him for that. Amen. Amen. All right, let us stand. All right. Lord, how we thank you today, how we praise you, how we lift you up, God. We give you praise and glory and honor. It all belongs to you. Thank you, God, again for this offering we're about to receive. We pray, God, it is used for the building up of thy kingdom, the edifying of your people is our prayer. Thank you, God, again for your word and your spirit. We be careful, God, to give you praise and give you all the glory. Now unto him who is able to keep us from falling and present us without any spot or wrinkles, without blemishes, to the only wise God, our Savior, be majesty, be dominion, be glory, be power, for it's in Jesus' precious name we pray. And we do thank you, and the church say, amen, amen. You're in the hands of our ushers. God bless you.
Hello, I'm Pastor Price of St. John Baptist Church. I want to just thank you for watching us today. I want to encourage you to be one of our subscribers. If you're not already one of our subscribers, please subscribe to our Facebook page. Also, if you need more information about our church, there's a link below that you can click on and learn more about St. John Baptist Church. Also, if you want to give and support the work of the Lord that you have us doing here in San Antonio, you can go to our website. We have PayPal there. You can give and support the work of the Lord here in San Antonio. So glad again that you took the time out to watch us, and we hope you come back, visit with us again. Be blessed.